Ted Kennedy Jr., Melissa Manchester, Marsha Mason, Amanda McBroom, Tony Melendez, Gary Morris, Kenny Rogers, Michael Tucker, from Dublin, Ireland, U2, and special appearances by the President of the United States, George Bush, and Senator Edward M. Kennedy. ITT is proud to sponsor this evening's telecast of the first International Very Special Arts Festival Gala Performance. ITT, building businesses into leaders. Ladies and gentlemen, Michael Douglas.
Good evening. Good evening. When an actor prepares for a role, he tries as much as possible to put himself in the mind, the body, and the soul of the character he is to portray. On rare occasions, the actor will also be the playwright, and the play will be about the real experiences of the author. When that happens, an extra dimension is added to the performance, the dimension of absolute truth. And such a performance and such a play is the one that is now touring the country under the auspices of Access Theater, a theater company whose very name indicates their accessibility to all actors and writers. It was written by Neil Marcus, who has a rare neurological condition called dystonia. Now, this condition affects the muscles of the body, but has no effect on the thinking process, except perhaps to heighten it. Neil, over the past 10 years, has written convincingly and often humorously about his life and times. And his personal experiences often reflect the world in which we all live. And the result is the production of Neil Marcus's play, Storm Reading. Thank you, Neil. As the cast performs excerpts from the play, I'm going to read excerpts of Neil's notes about being involved in the always terrifying process of taking the author's imagination and placing it in full view of the public.
People are watching me. They're watching me all the time. They're watching me even when they're pretending not to watch me. They're watching me to see how well I do this thing called human. Every dream I ever had came true. The person I never thought I was or could be, I am.
The show must go on, even though I've got a pain in my hip and a hole in the sole of my foot. The show must go on, even though there's times during it when I get so tired, I feel like I'm going to die. I can't give up. The show must go on.
Hello, welcome to Burger Boy. Can I take your order?
Yeah. Very good. El cheese. Steak.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Are you all right?
Yeah.
Did you just order?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Okay.
Could we try this again, please?
All right.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
Cheese. burger.
You want a cheeseburger? Yes! Yes! He wants a cheeseburger!
Friday evening. I had trouble concentrating. I was scared. I thought I wasn't doing a good job of acting. Sunday matinee. Performance was the best. I was relaxed before going out on stage. I was yawning and laughing. I was almost playful with my opening lines, and I wanted a larger audience, more than the 500 who were there. I was like a hungry lion. Let me at him. I suppose the essence of the entire experience is summed up by this.
I believe I have a voice, words, feelings, observations, perceptions. Thoughts that can move the world. I am a storm, a cyclone of ideas, thunder and lightning, a warm summer's breeze, a gentle spring rain. Some people hide from storms. They close their shutters and doors and blinds. They steep themselves in their own darkness and rob themselves of the tumultuous journey and its exhilaration. Some people, when they see my twisted frame, my dystonic disarray, embrace the storm. Their eyes light up, and they rush to hug me as a long-lost brother, as if embracing a storm was food for their souls. I can teach you to read a storm.
Salutes very special artists, letting the potential in each of us shine through. ITT, building businesses into leaders.
It is time now to talk about the disabled, or rather listen to them, those who through disease or accident cannot do what most of us take for granted, speaking, hearing, controlling our bodies. And it's rather strange how those who cannot do those things make those of us who can a bit nervous when we are confronted with a disabled person. And we have a story about that this morning.
That's true, we do, Garrick. Well, for several weeks this past spring, the Access Theater in Santa Barbara, California, staged an incredible play called Storm Reading. The play consisted of a series of vignettes written by a young disabled man who also happened to be the star of the play. The play is about his life and the millions of others who live with a disability. At first glance, Storm Reading isn't easy to watch, but once you see it, it's impossible to forget.
I believe I have a voice, words, feelings, observations, perceptions, thoughts that can move the world.
The voice belongs to Roger Marcus. The words and the thoughts are those of his brother Neil. Neil Marcus can barely speak. His body can hardly move. But nonetheless, he is starring in a play, one he has written about his own life.
I am a storm, a cyclone of ideas, thunder and lightning.
Why are you a storm?
Because I'm determined to make a change in the world.
Because I'm determined to make a change in the world.
And he is doing just that.
Conversation with a guy in the laundromat.
Wow, it's not done yet. Do you come here a lot? I always wait till I run out of clean clothes before I come here.
Every time Neil Marcus appears on the stage, every time his brother's voice brings his writings to life, audiences are forced to confront their fears and discomfort about the disabled.
What are you doing? Here, why don't you, let me help you. Why don't you let me, I don't want you to get me in any trouble. Here, I want you to sit down. You sit down right here. You sit down, I'll do it. It's fine, I'll do it, let's go.
How does it make you feel when you go out there on that stage and perform your own words? Tell people how you feel.
It feels very good. I'm out there with everything I got.
It feels very good. I'm out there with everything I got.
What is the message you're trying to convey?
People need a more exposure in the world.
Well, I think that disabled people need more exposure out in the world.
Roger Marcus is Neil's older brother. It was his idea to turn Neil's writings into a play.
We're trying to break down people's barriers towards, of course, disability, but also towards their own lives.
Growing up, he often acted as his brother's caretaker. Now they live in separate cities, but their closeness still shows.
Claire, you're beautiful.
I feel very connected to Neil. Sometimes people don't understand what he says, and so I have often filled in the role of interpreter, saying his words, repeating them for people, making him accessible to people.
What do people think initially when this play begins?
Oh dear. I'm here watching someone and I can't understand them. And there's a level of fear. And then we slice through that. I think they think, my goodness, he's enjoying himself. Here's a person who looks and acts like they're disabled. He's having so much fun in his life. Maybe I can have fun in my life.
Should I help you? I'd be glad to help. Or should I mind my own business? I mind my own business.
Neil Marcus spent an idyllic childhood playing with his four older brothers and sisters. But his world changed suddenly and drastically when, at the age of 8, he became afflicted with a rare neurological disorder called dystonia.
I couldn't hold a pen.
I couldn't hold a pencil. And I started limping. I thought I was losing my mind.
Today at 34, his body is racked by spasms over which he has no control. But his mind is brilliantly clear.
Good to see you.
He's a well-known figure on his hometown streets of Berkeley, California, where he's joined the growing movement of disabled people fighting for recognition and respect.
I am not an outcast. I want to be connected with people. It's just like you.
I don't want to feel like an outcast. I want to be feel connected with people just like you do.
Hi, Neil. Hi, Neil.
Neil's goal is for everyone to look beyond what they see. When he's not writing or editing his newsletter for the disabled, he spends his day reaching out to friends like Mark, who has spent most of his life in an iron lung.
Have you seen my poetry?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
That was excellent. I'm glad you liked it.
He is the voice of a right philosophy. He acts out a right philosophy in a beautiful way, and he is touching people.
There are disabled people like myself, and movie stars look at me in awe, and I wonder, am I a movie star?
Not yet, but his performance is bringing him recognition and adulation and giving hope to those who have felt limited by life.
I understand.
I understand that the world wants you to believe that you're insignificant.
And you know you're not.
Yeah.
Yes.
That's a big victory.
I think it's the biggest.
I think it's the biggest victory.
A victory Neil says he would never have attained without his family's support. In French, Roger sings his brother a song of love. Neil and Roger Marcus will be back in Santa Barbara this fall, and there are plans to take Storm Reading on the road next year. The success of the play proves that Neil Marcus does have a voice and that it is being heard.